Last night, the dumpster played witness to a shooting. The media won't report for fear of offending until it's too big to go on ignoring. And they'll make sure to put the blame on the shoulders of who deserves it, the man in the ICU. Fighting to live with a bullet working its way towards his heart, the one who was asking for it. Because when he got dressed that night, he might as well have put the gun to his own head, a red t-shirt, jeans, and sneakers, as if he didn't know that back alley gun toters can't stand such a potent combination, can't control themselves around such a display, get a little trigger happy around clothing choices so provocative. I mean, how could you expect him to keep his gun in his pants after all that temptation he was asking for it? The minute he walked into that back alley, as if he didn't know that shortcuts are only for self-made sitting ducks, it's really his own fault for putting himself in a dangerous situation. And let's be honest, we all know he enjoyed it a little bit. I mean, who wouldn't have felt a thrill run up their leg at the sight of that gun so big and strong? I bet he wanted to touch it. But the danger of the situation made him a little hot under the collar, that once the bullet penetrated his body, he stopped resisting, because everyone knows that all he needed was a little good shooting to remind him of the true pleasure to be found in knowing one's place.
Come on.
And he can tell all the lies he wants to from his hospital bedroom, but they will only ask him questions. When he pulled out his gun, did you tell him no loud enough? Could he have mistaken your soft moan of terror for consent? Don't try to tell anyone your story. No one will believe you. Are you sure you even got shot? Are you sure that you want to ruin somebody else's life with this accusation? Are you sure you aren't just looking for attention? Don't try to tell us that he left you bloodied and broken. That you flinch at the sight of every man who comes around a corner. Don't run away from your problems. You will be called weak. Don't try to claim PTSD. That's only for soldiers. Don't try to get him arrested. Because even with the physical signs all over your body, they'll still ask if you were partly responsible. Were you drunk that night?
Mom.
Was he? Intoxication can lead to a lack of responsibility. Don't tell anyone. Because isn't it better that your silence kill you softly than that anyone else have to feel guilty, even if you're still stuck in that back alley waiting for the release of his pistol for the pain to be over? Act normal, or they'll lock you up. Don't argue that the questions they ask you don't leave room for the truth, because everyone knows. Some people just shoot. So easy.
Give it a one more time for the poet from Chapel Hill, everybody.